Hi guys, it's Adam and welcome to another video. So I am just in the shed today. I'm doing a sort out. I've literally just got back. I've been back a few days, but God, there's been so much stuff that I need to do. So what I'm gonna do is do the shed. Then I've got tons of other stuff to do. My to-do list for the last few days have been astronomical. They've been ridiculous. So yeah, I've just got to get on today, do this, and then I can get on with some of the actual proper summer stuff that I need to do. I've got loads of YouTube stuff to do as well, as many people are aware of. So yeah, I'll just give you a look around at the shed first off. We'll see where we're at. I really don't even know what I'm doing. I've just come in here. I know that I want to do some sort of sort out. I know that I want to do some sort of clean, but I don't really know other than that. So we're just going to go for it. We'll see what comes out, basically. So obviously, most of you will be aware of what the shed is now looking like. It's kind of a 50-50 split between sort of more casual YouTube-y kind of backdrops and things here. And obviously, I use this process, this table for processing, or I will be doing in the next few weeks. Obviously, I haven't done since I've been at university. And then we just got like miscellaneous bits and bobs on there. I just need like really just sort through things and stuff. Got the Lego on the back there. And then this is all basically all here is stock that obviously isn't listed or anything like that, that could be listed. So plenty of stuff on there. And then this side was kind of stuff from my room. And there's loads of stuff out there as well, as you can see. Stuff from my room that has just been placed in the shed because there's literally nowhere else to put it. So I'm going to put this back on here. I'm going to take everything off first and then do a clean, because I need to get all the cobwebs out, all the rest of it. You see, like, I don't know what I mean, see up there, but there's like just cobwebs everywhere. Coming down here, there's like mental cobwebs, because I think I've got, I don't know exactly what they are. There's a dead spider, actually. I don't know exactly what they are. They might be wolf spiders, I'm not certain, but they're certainly not orb weavers or anything like that. So yeah, I just want to get them all out, because I don't really like having them in here, to be honest. It's not a very nice experience when you come into the shed and there's just cobwebs everywhere and the spiders crawling and all the rest of it. So yeah, I need to get them out. I don't know what I'm going to do with that. See, I want to take that down. That doesn't need to be there. I don't know what I'm going to do with the green screen, because I think I might need that upstairs. And yeah, I just don't know. It really needs a think about it as well as a sort, and just try and get some sort of idea of what's going to go on in here over summer, and then I can understand practically how I need to arrange it and stuff. So I think that's going to be the first thing, just have a 5 or 10 minute think about what I want from this space before I start going in and just doing anything crazy. But what I can do straight away is I can have a look at the clean. So I will do the clean first, I think. So I have basically taken everything out now and it's all sorted. I just need to do the clean now, and it's actually not looking too bad at all. It's not really dirty on the shelves or anything in particular, but I'm going to give it a wipe anyway since I've been away for a few months. There's also a box on there that I haven't got off, so I'll have to get that off. Then obviously I'm going to wipe where the cobwebs are. I'm using these really, really good big and strong Dettol wipes. Now these are quite expensive. Well, I say expensive, not like really expensive or anything, but you can get cheaper wipes is what I'm saying. However, if you go on eBay, you can get them in bulk and you can get them a bit cheaper, and they are really good. So I stick to them. I also have some other smaller wipes as well that I use. I use those for cleaning my bathroom, actually. I'm a bit of a weird person. I really like cleaning my bathroom. I love getting in there. I love cleaning right all around the bowl and everything. And, you know, anyway, it doesn't matter. Too much information, right? So I'm going to get in there on all these shelves and I'm going to give these a right old clean. And yeah, and we'll see how it's looking after that. And then what I'm going to do, you see all that stuff behind me, I'm going to take all that off and I'm going to rearrange it, because I want it rearranged. Tenant will probably stay where he is. The mannequin will probably go somewhere else, maybe, if I can find somewhere. And then that stuff on that shelf there, you know, I need to rearrange and sort out of that. Maybe some of that needs going somewhere else. I don't know. But yeah, it, you know, I think it'll be all right. I think we'll be doing all right. So there is a massive spider in the shed. Well, there was before. I've had my lunch now. And I don't know whether it's still in here. But it was mass. I mean, I'm talking mass. This wasn't like a little, like this was a, like, yeah. Like, God, it was big. It was behind that curtain there. Behind that curtain there. And I've just like lifted back the curtain and it's not there. And I don't like it because it was huge. I could deal with the little one down there. That was all right. It was about like a little one like that-ish. And, but this one, this, whoa, this was, it was a big one. Jesus. I think it was a wolf spider, but I don't know. But anyway, we're going to set you down here. We'll set you down here and then we'll just kind of put some stuff back. And if it gets me, if you just see it like coming down, one sec. If you just like see it coming down here and I've got my back turned, just let me know because it'll be horrible. I just thought as well, actually, this spider situation is very, very interesting because it gives us a good practical look at Jungian psychology. So, obviously, the spider is representative of the animal archetype, and obviously because of the psychoid nature of archetypes, that is the way in which they can affect your physiology and your behaviour and things like that, the spider, the knowledge of the spider goes to affect my, obviously, my physical body and my behaviour in the way of, well, my heart rate's increased, there's fear responses that lead me to go out of the shed, all the rest of it, right? Quite easy. Oh, just thought, see what I mean? See, there we go. That's psychonaked nature of the archetype, because I thought I saw it, and then I got a little perception, sense perception on my foot, thinking it was down there. Anyway, so what happened then is, of course, my anima gets a little bit tetchy. The negative side of my anima comes through, my negative emotionality comes through, and then what happens is it affects what I'm doing in the shed, because I've got that constant present thought of the animal archetype, the spider, the image of the spider in my kind of semi-conscious. So then when I'm coming in here to rearrange things and sort things out, my consciousness is impeded a little bit because I can't, my behavior's impeded. I won't be able to do things with the same level of functionality. So of course, like you can see on these shelves here, I've been putting things back in, but I've been putting things back in quite quickly because I know that the spider's in here. I'm like, oh, I don't really want to be in here for that long. So then I'm unconscientiously putting things on the shelves. I'm not as conscientious with the way I'm doing it. And conscientiousness really is associated with the positive anima, the positive side of the feminine, and the positive side of the internal feminine of the masculine. And so if I am to overcome the anima in this particular situation, I need to come in here, ignore the spider, and really sort through these shelves conscientiously. Then I get back the positive side of the anima, positive emotionality. Now, of course, the correct thing to do would be to actually locate the spider, try and get it out somehow and release it. And that would be the ultimate highest form of the positive manifestation of the anima in this situation. And, well, actually, it's kind of like the syzygy, the union of the anima and the animus, because I've got the spirit there of the animus coming in to say, let's go and grab this spider and take it out. But also I've got the positive emotionality of the anima saying, well, let's take it out rather than kill it. So then you've got the union of the animal animus coming in a situation that kind of gives you a little bit of a fleeting access to a really, really positive, high manifestation of your particular personality expressed in a particular situation, and more so slightly more so the feminine part of the personality as well. But you could argue the mana masculine personality, you know, you could argue all these different things actually, because there's a lot going on in a situation like this. So what I'm doing now, of course, is I'm recognising that to try and overcome the anima and to conscientiously sort out these shelves rather than have my kind of semi-conscious attention being taken away from me in my behaviour with regards to wondering where the spider is in here. Now, I'm not going to take out the spider because that's too much for me, man. That's too much for me at the moment. So I'm using archetypal behaviourism, which is the little psychology that I've developed and, partially developed at the moment, not fully developed. And I'm doing behavioural shaping, which is where I will slowly come in, do a few bits, not be too harsh on myself, then go out again. And then, etc., you know, do that over the next few days until, you know, the situation is solved, resolved, etc. And that'll be cool. So there we go. That's what you have to do with psychology. So I've put everything back, as you can see. But I have a problem because I've got those things there and some more hats in another box. And they're a bit bulky and a bit big, and I don't really... They went there, and it's not a bad place, but I just don't like clutter in here. I don't just like unnecessary stuff in here. So I might put the hat stand back, but I don't know about that other box. Or maybe I might put the other box back, but not the hat stand. There's just some random bits and bobs on here. This was an eBay order that they've not paid yet, so I need to... Well, I've already followed that up, actually. I've already sent a payment reminder, but I need to double-check on that. I need to wonder whether the green screen is going back in the house or not. Do a little bit of tidying up of this bad boy. Just a very, very brief look at the Lego, nothing crazy. But yeah, I don't think I've got another box, so I don't know how I'm going to do this now. Right, so I'm over here. I managed to find some boxes for them hats. I put them in those boxes there. As you can see, there's loads of hats there. Yeah, I just had a very brief clear off this table. There's a few bits and bobs that I took inside. There was those Lego bits that I got off here. I'm not going to change any of the Lego, actually, because as you can see, I mean, it looks pretty fine. It's pretty in order. I just put those up there. Now, just before anyone says, I don't ever put boxes on top of boxes like that. Don't do it, because they can sometimes get concaved or anything like that. Also, the other way you never store Lego is boxes flipped around that way and then stacked up that way. Don't ever do that. That's worse than that, actually. That's not so bad, to be honest. But yeah, if you've got them like this way down and then packed on top of each other like that, don't do that. That is really bad. So I just stack them like that, as you can see. I've not actually got that many. I know it looks like a fair few, but I've not actually got that many Lego sets, to be honest, at the moment. It, you know, with university and all the rest of it, even just before university when I bought these, I couldn't spend much money. I still can't really spend that much money, so it is a bit of a shame. And then I've got my little display on there. Now, I'm probably gonna leave this. I don't think I'm gonna change anything on it, because the thing is, I've not really thought about it so much, so I need to have a think about it to see what I can put up there. If you've got any ideas on what I can put up there, let me know, and I will sort something out, and I can get them bought. If you see something online that you think, oh, that'll look cool on the display, just message me on Instagram or something. My Instagram will be down below in the description, and I will have a look, see if I like it, and if I like it, it'll go up there. So yeah, just let me know, and so I'll have a think about that before I do anything. I do want to change it out. It's a bit random in it at the moment. We've got a bloody Lego set there, and then a little what do you even call those, a little film take thing, and then that was from Zaheer that I wanted to keep up there, but I don't know, I might put that somewhere else now. That was that thing from Thursday Talks. We've got a random ad show mug that I don't even sell anymore. We've got Doctor Who figure, and then we've got my poetry book. So yeah, it's really random, and God knows what this is. What we did was we took a shelf down not long ago. Well, I say not longer, about a year ago now. We took a shelf down about a year ago, yeah. I don't know. I mean, what do I do with this space, really? God knows. I haven't a clue. But I'm going to put the Doctor Who thing back up there. Oh, there's a bubble up there. I didn't even realise there was a bubble up there. That's all my eBay stuff under there, obviously. I've not actually got... Well, I suppose I've got a few packaging bits and bobs at the moment. I need to take that to the bin. I've got random people's merch up here. I've got George Rossi's merch. I've got two Ozzy Swifters merch. And I've got, I've got Cookie Mahaden's merch. And I've got Andrew Monumental's merch. I've got loads of different merch in it. So yeah, I need to sort something with them. I was going to do some sort of video with them, modelling them. So I might do that still, to be honest. I've got a few bits of merch here I could model. I've got a random box there that can go out. Is there anything in it? There's nothing in it. I'm just going to tip that. Well, you know, put it in my bin. So yeah, I'm going to take the green screen out of here. That's something that I can do. I'll probably have that upstairs. I don't see why not. So yeah, that's that. So then I will be done. I'm not going to do the... what do you call it? I'm not going to do the wipes on there where all them cobwebs are, because there is still spiders in there and everything. So I'm going to wait and sort that some other time. I'm also going to get a spider repeller for in here. I can attach it to that thing up there. Going to get a spider repeller. And then that's a humane way of keeping the spider hopefully at bay. It's always been bad in here for spiders. Always, always, always. But, you know, I mean, there's not much you can do really. So, yeah, I'm going to do that anyway. Pull out there and see if that helps. But other than that, that's that. So I'm just going to have a very quick sort of this and then I'll be done. So what I'll do is I'll just do a final segment sort of to sign off off the video in a bit. So I will sign off now. It's actually not looking too different at all in here. It's pretty the same as when I first came in here. Did I come in here this morning? I think it was this morning actually now. But yeah, I've just had to tidy up these shelves. Just a little bit of a rearrange of the items and a little bit of a rearrange of that bit, more so down there rather than up on those shelves. As I say, just got to do a quick, I need to scout out some things for that shelf up there. And if I do buy any more Lego, I will have a rearrange of that shelf there. But it's given me a bit of perspective and a bit of an idea of where I'm going over the next few weeks, because what I needed to do first couple of days back, come in here and get square. Know what I've got here and just understand, you know, what I can utilize, what I can pull out, what I can photograph, and where I need to go moving forward, instead of kind of not doing a little bit of a sort out and it kind of being, oh, well, I'll just pull this off the shelf and all the rest of it, rather than doing the sort out and getting it square. So yeah, happy that I've done that. I've got loads of other jobs left to do today. It's about 2-3 o'clock, I would guess. So yeah, I need to get on with some of those, but I will leave this video here, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. So see you very soon, guys.